On July 31st, their sex tech startups were protesting outside of Facebook offices because social networks such as Facebook and Instagram do not allow you to have different, like vibrators and things are not allowed to be advertised as part of Facebook or Instagram ads. No matter how tasteful the ads are, they're a big giant no-no because they're considered too sexually explicit. Like the only way you can get anything along any sort of lines is Facebook will let it through if it's like a contraceptive or for family planning, but you can get like erectile dysfunction ads on there, but you can't have like,
hey, they're in your podcast. Why not? I actually had somebody message me and said, please, please, please never have Blue Chew as a sponsor because they're like on everything and the jokes are getting bad.
It's awful. And like, and it's, and they're talking about how, you know, you could do this really nice, tasteful ad, but you can make this illusion, you know, or have this other ad where it's like a limp plant and you're talking about some sort of blue pill and it's from Hims. They have a whole line of very interesting ads, but it's totally okay. But you can't just have these, you know, sex toys kind of a thing. And yeah, because Facebook's rules are it has to be contraceptive and not focus on sexual pleasure or sexual enhancement. It must be targeted to people 18 and over, which is really weird because you really can't target under 18. On Facebook ads to begin with, they're really not a big fan of that because you're not supposed to be doing that. But they had a big protest outside. And then something I dropped in there is they created this website called approvednotapproved.com. And if you go through there, it's kind of a quiz.
Okay.
And you can see they'll give you an ad and you decide whether or not the advertisers approve the ad or not. And this is Facebook, Instagram, and I believe there was a couple different, I think in Boston and another cities, maybe New York's mass transit, they tried to buy an ad in one of their trains and they got a big giant no for that too. So you can flip through and kind of look at it and go, oh, this is interesting. And then,
by the way, I'm just going not approved for these so far, and I'm pretty good on this. Let's see. This, oh, I think I saw this one. Well, this one's just straight toys for sex, and there are things and they don't look like anything, and I'm saying not approved. It's rejected. Ads were not approved to run in New York City subways. Oh, there's the ones you were just talking about. Let's see, manscaped.com, and it's a plastic bag with two oranges in it.
Yeah. I'm that was approved.
Not approved. It was approved! Ran on Facebook and probably does.
Didn't they have they had an ad on something big, like the Super Bowl or...
Yeah.
Like, they had an ad on something, and I was surprised.
Oh, Manscaped. Oh, yeah. Well, you know, TV just wants money at this point. It'll take it from anybody at this point. Well, Katie, you talked about it here, your issues, but I know somebody was posting a wrestling video, and the still had a lot of skin in it, because these are guys in tighties, okay? And he got knocked for sexually explicit. it was just a guy laying on the mat, so...
I think that algorithm's off because I've heard of a lot of people complaining. Off.
Have you seen there's the algorithm and there's a lot of because I was talking to somebody else about this the other night and they were like, yeah, then you just rerun it and you'll get approved because they'll like a person will see and say, oh no, this is something else. But then there's Katie, I know you've read the article that we had going around in Slack of the people that are manually looking at posts that have been reported and how bad of a situation that is. I think, do you remember who had that article? Was that a Wired article perhaps?
I think it might've been. Yeah.
So
not Verge. What was it called? Another place like that. But this one is very much like we're not going to push like women forward products, but you know, it's cool talking about erectile dysfunction. Do you know what I mean? Like it's such a double standard with things that it's not, They just need to reevaluate a lot of what they're letting through and what they're not letting through and just kind of be a little bit more fair.
It's so large of a problem. You know, I don't know how they could get their hands on it.
There's
a lot of stuff that really
it's a changing a whole conversation too.
It is.
You're taking something that's okay to be talked about in public and something that's not, that should be okay too, because we're not having those safe sex and actual adult conversations about sex because it's so taboo.
Yeah. And you can completely, like, every time you say, I don't want to see an ad, it's like, I don't see this as appropriate. Like, I think, you know, that is an option. You kind of opt out of that type of ad can be an idea too.
Well, hey, someone had brought up in a conversation that Facebook, if you look at your ads, they're very much targeted for you. Mm-hmm. You know what I mean? They were able to tell this lady was pregnant. They were able to tell that another person, you know, was getting married, you know, very specific ad. You know, they're able to tell that, oh, you know what? They might not be interested in this. I should probably not show it to them. But they're just like, nope, nope, nope.